It's Halloween, and Kepler and I are going to show you three impossible science hacks so that you can step up your Halloween game this year. Welcome to Impossible Science.
Come on, get up. We got work to do.
Tired of old Halloween decorations? Well, let me show you how to make shrunken apple heads. These are awesome. I used to make these when I was a kid with my family. They're absolutely right. You can make a zombie. You can make your friends. That's one of my favorites, is trying to make your friends, because what happens, you can try to carve their face, and as they shrivel up, you can say, this is what I think you're gonna look like when you get older. It's an absolute right, and it's really easy to do. You just need some granny apples, some lemon juice, and some salt. Now, the mixture you're gonna make is 2 tablespoons of salt for every 2 cups of lemon juice. When you have your granny apples, you wanna skin them to remove all of the outside layer, and you wanna soak them in your solution for about 20 minutes. Now, the lemon and the salt actually prevent the apple from turning brown as you do this process. You soak them again for another 20 minutes. So when you carve your apples, you wanna make sure that all the features are really pronounced. You wanna make really deep incisions for the nose and for the eyes and for the lips. That's because as you dehydrate these apples, it's gonna become more and more shriveled down and wrinkled. And the deeper the features in the carving makes for a better feature at the end. Now, once you're done carving them and they've soaked, you just put them out on a windowsill. Now, it takes about a week for them to shrink down, but if you wanna speed up the process, all you need is a dehydrator or even an air fryer, and you can possibly even use your oven. Putting it at about 170 degrees for about an hour leads you into this guy, right? But if you were to put it in your window, this would be after 1 day, this would be after 2 days. So you can see the process takes a lot longer if you're just gonna let it sit out. But once you're done, well, then you can actually put in little beans, like these are black-eyed peas for eyeballs. That's great. I put a lima bean inside there and I drew the teeth. And you can actually just use markers and wool for the hair, and you can actually have a riot. And you can decorate these all over the house. Put them on little sticks, put them in the plants. You can put them on strings or put them on little coat hangers and hang them in your trees. They're absolutely fantastic for Halloween. Now, fog machines have become a staple of Halloween and Halloween parties. But wanting to step up your spookiness? Yeah, low-lying fog machines are way cooler. Now, to have a low-lying fog effect, you can actually use any fog machine. Now, when you use any type of fog machine, normally the smoke comes out and it fills up a room with a cloud. That's because the smoke is, and the fog is warm. All we need to do is cool it off. Hot air rises, well, cool air will fall to the ground. And we're gonna do that by building a chiller. You can use an old ice chest or cooler. And what you do is you cut out a hole on both sides. Now, you want to cut a hole that's about 4 inches off the bottom, because we're going to be using ice, and the ice will melt, so you want a place for the water to collect. By the way, if you can find a cooler that has a drainage plug in it, that also helps. You're going to need a couple pieces of 2x4s that are actually able to fit inside your cooler, and then you need some chicken wire. And the chicken wire goes right on top of the 2x4s. We're going to be filling this up with ice. Now, the chicken wire prevents the ice from falling all the way down to the bottom. Now, a lot of people have suggested using a block of dry ice or even just a block of ice. Well, the problem is we want the fog to come in through one side, cool off, and go out the other side. And if there's a solid block of ice, the same as your ice chest in there, there's no way for the fog to go through it. And the reason we have a trough on the bottom is to not only collect the water, but it allows the cool fog that has cooled down to fall to the bottom and then go out the air duct on the other side. Now, because I use air ducts after I've cut the hole, I put an air duct piece here. It allows me to put a hose right on it. Now I just wrap this in tape, fill this with ice, wrap the outside with tape to seal it off as best as I can, and you're good to go. Now for kind of the trickiest part. Not all fog machines have a standard outlet where the fog comes out. In fact, most of them spray out a condensed form of fog, so it's pulling in air to mix with that spray to make the cloud that you're used to seeing. So that also means we don't want this airtight to this. We want it to pull in air. And to do that, you just want to line out the nozzle from your fog machine to the cooler. And to do that, I'm just going to use a couple blocks of wood so that this raises up. And you just place it as close as you can. Now, that also does mean that some of the fog will leak out over here, which is okay, no one will notice. But it does allow for air to pass in from this nozzle as it sucks in and pushes the fog through the ice. Now we're ready to fog. Wow, look at that. Spooky, right? Now every Halloween needs a trick, and I'm gonna show you a simple build that will scare your friends. Now to build this, you're gonna need a full-size skeleton, some wooden dowels, some zip ties, a pair of scissors, a chair with some mesh or lattice here so you can see through it, and some black fabric. Now the fabric is really important. And why is this so important? Well, you want a fabric that's actually see-through when it's up to your face. Now, what you need with the wooden dowels is we're either gonna drill through them or you can put a zip tie on them, and we're gonna zip tie them to each hand. Another option is to drill through it, put a zip tie to another zip tie. That gives it a little bit more freedom and play. You do it to both hands, and I paint them black. That's my own preference because it makes it a little bit more spooky because they won't see the black sticks against the black cloth. Take your black fabric, cover your chair, and tuck it in as if somebody was sitting in it. Then we need a zip tie through the fabric to the back wall. Now, if it's an old chair, you can actually just drill two holes, or you can actually pop holes in the fabric where the mesh is. Now, we're gonna zip tie the skeleton, the base, his hips, to the back of the chair, all right? And it's really easy to do. Black zip ties on a black background, you won't see it, but you can actually use this pelvic bone to actually zip tie them. Next, you cut holes in the fabric so that these wooden dowels can go underneath the arms. Because we picked this fabric with a porch light on, we can actually see through to this side, but you can't see through this way. And if I hide behind this chair, I can puppeteer this skeleton and get a great Halloween scare. Now, this works for a couple reasons. One, no one's expecting a skeleton to be a puppet. But two, because it's a skeleton, no one thinks there's any mechanics going on, which leads to a great laugh.
Give me your candy.
Happy Halloween! Well, that's it. I hope you enjoyed this special Halloween episode. And if you enjoyed the episode, make sure you like the video and share it with your friends. And if you try any of these out, let me know in the comments below. And until next time, stay curious. Because the right question changes everything. Happy Halloween!